host racer sessions here every Sunday, as well as multiple music events and festivals throughout the year. And what's special about tonight, in addition to being incredibly festive, is that it's a fundraiser for Urban Rest Stop, which is a local nonprofit organization that provides restroom, laundry, and shower facilities for people experiencing homelessness in the greater King County area. So it's very, very close to the city, very close to us, and very important for those people that are dealing with that this time of year. So throughout the rest of the night, we have an opportunity to donate your cash, your digital money, your physical money. All of that will be available to you, so we're going to be taking donations throughout the night. And we have a very fun, very full stage and full night of great music. So before I turn it over to a very special menorah lighting, I would like to say that Scrambler will be starting shortly thereafter.
If anyone would like to join us for the menorah lighting, if that's part of your lifestyle, your upbringing, something you'd like to be a part of, feel free to come and join us for this part. We're going to say the first three blessings of the first night of Hanukkah.
Shall I, Thank you. Thank you. Christian Pincock and his lovely festive Scrambler. Come out! So yeah, we're gonna take a quick second to clear a little bit of space on the stage for the next act. And while we're doing that, great opportunity to donate to Urban Rest Stop, which we're gonna be taking donations all night for that. Also, great opportunity to buy a drink, support Cafe Racer, meet somebody new, revel in just the general holiday merriment. And whilst that's happening, we have a very, very, very special reading of Twas the Night Before Christmas from Ian Murdoch, who unfortunately can't be here right now, but he sent this as his visual representation of himself for the night. But he sent us a really lovely audio recording that's going to be playing throughout the space while we turn the stage over, and we'll be accompanied by a few musicians on stage? Potentially. Potentially. We don't know. That's the beauty of it. But we do know that Ian's lovely voice will be reading us what I can only guess is a very, very interesting Twas the Night Before Christmas. So turn the stage over. We're going to be here. We're going to be back. Enjoy yourselves.
Oh yeah. Right? I come here a lot for the research sessions. But yeah, sometimes just hang out. How about you?
Yeah,
are you friends with the... Last time I saw Amethyst, the Amethyst.
I know Amethyst.
Okay.
Yeah.
She's cool.
Yeah. She's a lot of music, yeah.
Wherever the music's happening. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Were you with Joe?
Well, and Claire at their place.
Oh, cool. I think about Joe. I just saw our friend Simon today. How's Joe doing?
He's all right.
Yeah, he's really hanging in there. He's got some stuff going on.
Yeah, he does. Yeah.
Cool. So I'm going to put this away. I might even just bring this home. I don't know.
My little elves, welcome back. Okay, we are going to start a retelling, a very accurate retelling of "Twas the Night Before Christmas" by one disembodied Ian Murdoch, represented here by Santa Squid.
Yeah.
Santa Squid. We have musicians placed throughout the venue. We ask you to bring your voices down and tune in. And we'll be here reminding you all night. We are collecting donations in the monetary and fiscal forms for Urban Rest Stop, who provides clean and safe places to shower and bathe and be for folks experiencing homelessness. Their cause is something that we really appreciate. Our donation station is right here in the corner, just past the, whatever you want to call it, this archway into the main room. So we'll be collecting donations all night. In the meantime, we give you Ian Murdoch.
Thank you. do. Pop. Skip. Shorter. The passing harder. Cutting deeper. I can't find the marks anymore. My pass sucked. The middle as I bleed. But now, my time. I missed something.
As you may have noticed, we're having technical difficulties. Hold tight. Keep getting your drinks, talking amongst yourselves, donating your sweet, sweet cash and warm clothing to Urban Rest Stop. And we'll be back in a second. What will probably happen is those sweet, sweet musicians who are accompanying our digital Ian Murdoch will simply play their instruments in this main room. So if you want to get the full storytelling and improvised experience, follow the sound of my voice to the stage. And that's where it'll all happen. Uno momento.
Has sucked a candy.
Down. check, 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 tick, 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 tick.
Holding tight. It's really, truly, 'twas the night before Christmas storytelling time. Get ready.
It was the night before Xanax, and all through the... Wait, let me back this up. I read about this dream once on Dreamyell, the Yelp for dreams. And too much time had gone by since... Time had had an oil change. It's getting cold out, the days are getting shorter, but passing harder, cutting deeper. I can't find the marks anymore. My past sucked a candy cane into a shank, so I could feel sentimental as I bleed. But now, my time holes are loose and indifferent, so maybe I missed something, but did you just criticize the way I peel shrimp? You seem to be under a lot of pressure, so let me unburden you by delivering the good news. For lo, the angels said unto me, let no man born of a woman teach you how to peel shrimp. Now, let us set aside the cis-exist assumptions of that for a moment and retreat from the ice cave. And back to my review of this peppermint and Sitka spruce scented candle. Be sure to pound that subscribe button the way these high citrus notes pound the front of the palate. Make you cough until your belly shook like a bowl full of happiness, evading the overeager grasping of your greedy, undeserving fingers of sentience. Unable to handle all that pine, you cough out a drawbridge, then get stuck waiting for passing sailboats of unbearable truths. You get out of your car and Jackie Chan your way into town. You stand before a decorated storefront, clutching an oily bag of a pastry you didn't quite finish, wondering if it's better used as a Molotov cocktail or a harbinger of holiday cheer. Then your eyes focus on your faded reflection in the foreground. It becomes the watermark, the brand of your experience. Your eyes hog all the reflective light, the reflected light. Everybody knows what you're enjoying, and it's the wrong thing. Every morsel of joy you allow yourself to feel is yanked from someone far more deserving. God is everybody except for you. This year, instead of getting a Christmas tree, I just stood really still in the corner and bragged about myself until someone threw me into a ditch. In fact, I did see Mommy kissing Santa Claus, I said before my psychiatrist adjusted my lithium dosage. I fill my stocking every night with medicated beef Skittles. It's a weapon and a healthy snack. If I fill my mouth with them and sit before the fireplace while remembering everything I've ever done wrong, and just at the right time I blow them out of my mouth, they awaken as the night bees. The night bees, piercing the frosty air to gather data like pollen. They return to my body when I inhale. Like an accordion sucks down a belt of scotch. I'm ready to shower the world with my opinions. If I only had a rib cage. If I only had a rib cage. If I only had a rib cage. I think the very notion of a good list and a naughty list promotes a neoliberal agenda of individualism, and it's messed up that Santa Claus rides around in a fire engine because, like, what about all the fire children? They haven't all been bad. In fact, one of them just lit this pumpkin leather soy wax candle with a wooden wick, which is certain to deliver the sensation of dried fruit and cinnamon to the back of your nose. Be sure to assault that subscribe button, kiddies. It knows what it did. Well, my oven broke, so my cookies were baked using light from stars who were wished upon, but the wish never came true because it was too ironic. They landed in my cereal box of oops, all Vince Guaraldi chords. I ate box after box until my clothes wouldn't fit. If I wanted to leave the house, I have to wear a blanket. I chomped snowflakes on the way to work, giving psychiatric advice for 5 cents. In a moment of passion, passing a bonfire, I tossed in my weekly ration of peanut-based protein. They threw me into the gulag. After 12 months of damp silence, they take me to meet their leader, who sits on an end table, burning diligently beneath the mistletoe. The leader is a pear butter pecan set of votive candles with an earthy balance of smooth sweetness and sentimental whimsy we can all believe in, whose only demand is that you quell that subscribe button like a populist uprising. I achieve atemporal understanding of my part in history and remember a time before there were lighters. The working class had to carry lit candles with them, and the candles made no demands. They have been post-dating my dream journal entries. I tore out those pages until I had the mind of a child again. I crumpled my manuscript of "It's a Communist Dictatorship, Charlie Brown." And then I said to no one in particular, "If you're upset about something, but you don't want to do anything about it, just drink change nog." Dear Santa, I am a series of disconnected actions on a centerless plane of unrelated impulses with no accountability, but I really want a bike and the latest Jonathan Franzen novel. Teacher says every time a bell rings, that's someone you've never met hating the idea of you based on clues you've left behind. Forgetting that you yank the same rope of French fries that connects everyone to their faults. Your oven is still broke, so you hold a nonstick baking sheet into the night sky and wish for your sim to envy your life for once. Then you toss your shame fries aside and use the baking sheet as a sled. You notice behind you, Santa's feeding your shame fries to his reindeer and weaving them into their harnesses. And I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight, "You can use evolution to justify anything. Anything! I mean, Merry Christmas to all, and to..." Oh, crap. All of my thoughts are being narrated by red and green fluorescent tube lighting against the wall behind me and falling to the ground and shattering. Stay back. Don't cut yourself on my thoughts. What a waste of resources. All these unnecessary words. They won't stop. Quick, someone teach me how to meditate. Is there a nonverbal language my brain has forgotten? Okay, take a deep breath. That's right. It's a ginger molasses coconut wax candle in a mason jar. The warming spice of ginger lures your palate into a lake to a lakeside cabin and tells you stories of treasured memories. Be sure to re-traumatize that subscribe button by telling its own harrowing story to impress some hottie at a party. Think about the hottie now. What gender are they? No matter what, you're wrong. Feel bad. Feel bad. Feel bad. Feel bad. But feel bad more slowly than your baking sheet sled as it travels uphill, stopping outside a decadent New Year's feast. You entreat entrance at their door, calling out, "Hey, let me in. I've got a few shame fries left in my pocket." After hours of pounding the door to no avail, you start eating your secret shame fries. Your body glows with each seasoned, savory bite. And you can peer through the walls and watch the tastefully rustic bacchanalia transpiring within. You're getting total FOMO, by which I mean frostbite, far outpacing the warm, glowing zestiness of your shame fries. In the distance, you see a new star is born. Then realize that your oven worked the whole time and your house is on fire. You remember what your grandmother said. When a house burns down, anything inside of it is probably dead. You fill your mouth with the rest of the shame fries and the cool rats the fire department wasn't able to save appear hovering before you. And they're way more interesting than they ever were before. You reach out to embrace them, and with them, fly in brightness and joy, beyond the reach of cold and hunger, of loneliness and pain and want. You are all with God now. And you can't put your finger on it, but God has a familiar aroma that is celebratory and sweet, but not cloying. And then it hits you, like the tangy notes of this winter candy apple soy wax candle. Right from the first waft, this is a clean burner that takes you on a freewheeling adventure of tartness with unexpected side quests of apricot and cinnamon. And isn't that what life's about? Make sure your frozen corpse squashes that subscribe button on its death rattle so that you can get into heaven. You don't want to miss out on these sharp whiffs of seasonally appropriate bliss.
Thank you, Ian, and thank you to Jesse and Steve and Jacob and Jim for improvising along with that beautiful story. One more round of applause for those folks. Okay, Maria Männistö is up next, and another reminder that we have donation pitcher jar over there, and so please visit that table, and if you're able to donate something for Urban Rest Stop, it'd be great. And here's Maria.
All right, I've been asked to have everyone step inward toward the stage. Come on in. It's cozy in here. Not so scary.
Maybe for dancers.
Yeah, who knows, maybe. All right, this is the 12 Tones of Christmas, and this first number is in honor of... Seattle has lost a lot of very fine musicians to distant lands, and so this is in honor of my two buddies here who are home for Christmas week. I'm dreaming tonight of a place I love even more than I usually do. And although I know it's a long road back, I promise you. With Arnold Schoenberg's Tone Row for Opus 42, the piano concerto, and so I have created a very lovely, if I do say so myself, variation of the charming Christmas carol Silver Bells using Opus 47 Tone Row. Christmas makes you feel emotional. It may bring parties or thoughts devotional. Whatever happens or what may be, here is what Christmas time means to me.
Soon it will be Christmas Day.
another tune inspired by a chipper holiday favorite, Piero Lunaire, which is not 12-tone, by the way. This is considered atonal, and I learned that Schoenberg was not a huge fan of the term atonal. He liked to call it pantonal, so Sprechstimme is a nice way to get all those little cracks between the notes. All right, so this is Piero O Tannenbaum. O Tannenbaum, O Tannenbaum, wie treu sind deine Blätterbäume. O Tannenbaum, O Tannenbaum, wie treu sind deine Blätterbäume. Du grünst nicht nur zur Sommerzeit, nein, auch im Winter, wenn es schneit. O Tannenbaum, o Tannenbaum, wie treu sind deine Blätter. Tannenbaum, du kannst mir sehr gefallen. Wie oft hat, o Tannenbaum, du kannst mir sehr gefallen. Wie oft hat mich zur Weihnachtszeit ein Baum von dir mich von Eis erfreut. O Tannenbaum, o Tannenbaum, mir sehr gefallen. O Tannenbaum, o Tannenbaum. For a little palate cleanser, this is Waltz of the Sugar Plum Fairies. Hit of the evening, this is Carol of the Bell.
I thought of a joke the other day.
What's that?
Oh, you're not even turned on. What was that joke?
What do you call somebody who likes to sing 12-tone Christmas carols?
I don't know.
A serial caroler. It sounded way better in my head.
That's not what I was expecting.
Tune for you all. This is Christmas Carol was made popular by the singing cowboy himself, Gene Autry. This is Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
To love and call him names. They never
won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee. Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history. You'll go down in history.
Everybody who's here, everyone who got here early, everyone who just showed up, you are all welcome. We're going to do something a little bit different as we reset the stage for the next act. We actually have a very special reading of a Hanukkah story upstairs. So if you aren't familiar, just follow the large crowd of people that are working their way upstairs. It will be read by Carol and Steve. It has become a table and chairs holiday party tradition. So Carol's actually waving. She's going to lead the charge up the stairs. And so make your way up there if you want to hear the story. We're also continuing to take donations for Urban Rest Stop. Yep. Coach Friedland has the donation bin over there. We take cards, we take cash, we take whatever you would love to offer us. So make your way upstairs to hear a story and then slowly work your way back down here for what is clearly the most anticipated performance of both the holiday season and the year. So.
Thank you. I have like Oh.
baby. You look good. I'm gonna unwrap your ass.
Oh, shit!
Just kidding, I already did. Baby number two.
Gross. Not me right now. Thank you.
Santa is coming to town. He is one bushy white beard away from singing to your souls with his smooth, croony, jazzy goodness, along with his sweet, sweet and babely Kringles. How many of y'all are Santa, Neil, and the Kringles fans already? How many of y'all are about to experience your first Santa, Neil, and the Kringles set? Ooh, nearly even. I friggin' love that. Okay, so quick rundown. This is the final set of the night, but it's not the final event of the night. We are still collecting cash money for Urban Rest Stop, along with checks, along with card donations, along with physical donations of clean clothes, books, socks, warm hats, gloves, all those things. It's in this back corner under this teal blue, what is that, a linen lamp where someone's pointing, right back there in the corner. Go there or find me. I will be coming around looking all of you in the eyes and trying to push our donation level, because we are nearly to $400. I want to see if we can get to $400 tonight. Can we do that? Can we get to $400? Yeah, I think we can. Sounds great. Okay, find me, give me your cash. Sounds great. Urban Rest Stop, great cause. After Santa, Neil, and the Kringles, we ain't done yet. We have a Christmas pinata, courtesy of one Jeremy Gonzalez. We will be busting that pinata full of candy and guilt outside after this set. Please join us. Take a whack. It's going to be a great time. Thank you again so much to everyone who is here tonight watching and participating. Thank you again so much to Scrambler. Can we get a round of applause? Thank you again so much to Ian Murdoch in digital form. Round of applause. Thank you again so much to Maria Männistö and Daniel Salka and Luke Bergman. Round of applause. Yeah. Thank you again so much to Carol and Steve. Round of applause. Thank you again so much to Cafe Racer and Caleb for throwing it down at the bar all year long and tonight. Round of applause. All right. Santa, how we doing? Oh God! Oh God! Santa? Santa, is that you? Santa? Oh my God! It's Santa, Neil, and the
thank you. please, one and all, come closer. Come in. Come come to Santa. Come, come.
Thank you.
Santa Neil and the Kringles. Performing music by Arnold Schoenberg's cousin, Mickey Schoenberg. We thank you. I'd like to slow it down a little. This one's called Silent Night.
Thank you. That's Matt Williams on the keys. Cameron Peace on the guitar. Balatero on the bass. Evan Woodle on the chimes, tambourine. Chris Icasiano on the drums. We'll be right back.
like to do one now by the biggest man in town, Mr. Kenny Gorlick. There is no other. This is Carol the Bells. You have been a lovely audience. Thank you so much. We have one more for you. But before we play, we'd like to give a special thank you to Scrambler, Maria Ministo's 12 Tones of Christmas. Yeah. And once again, thank you to the Kringles for playing with us tonight. Thank you. This one was called Santa Claus is Coming to Town.
to our 2019 production team. I want to give it up for Brian Greggs. I want to give it up for Casey Adams. I want to give it up for Jeremy Gonzalez. I want to give it up for Chris Icasiano. I want to give it up for myself. I did some work. I want to give a very special shout out to one specific Kringle, Mr. Evan Woodle, who hates being in the spotlight. But the Table and Chairs Holiday Show is Evan's passion project every year, and we're super thankful for his curatorial skills and for his love and for his heart. Thank you so much to Evan for making this show happen every year, and especially this year. Evan Woodle! Come on! And just a reminder, it's not over yet. We've still got a friggin' pinata, so head on outside. We're gonna smash that thing and really just end this holiday show and party with a literal bang. So please keep hanging out. It's not too late to give big. We can keep going. I've still got a card reader. I've still got a bowl of cash. Come find me. We'll be here all night. Tip your bartender. Hang out. Make some new friends. We'll see you soon. We'll be back in 2020 with a whole new season of Racer Sessions with our 10th year anniversary Cry and Roar Festival to celebrate 10 years of Racer Sessions at Cafe Racer. Let's go! That'll be January 24th through 26th. We've got a lineup posted in the back by the donation station. We'll see you soon. Thank you so much. Have a great night. Drive safe. Happy holidays. Merry Christmas. Happy Hanukkah. Thanks for being here. Peace out. Thank you. Come on!
Any butterfingers in there?
Oh.